Hello and welcome to this full tutorial and overview showing you all of the perks and benefits of using OpusClip. So in order to see this tool, you need to go to the URL. I'll put it in the description, opus.pro. Basically, this is an AI tool that takes long form video and you just drop the video link or upload the file here, and I'll show you how to do everything, and it converts it into highlighted short form content. So AI takes it, it figures out what it thinks to be the highest value and optimizes that and gives you titles. And you can see here, it's breaking it down into the name. It also gives you kind of grades for the hook, the flow, the value, the trend. And then it gives you kind of the subtitles. And I'll show you how to do all of this. So if you're a creator, a podcaster, looking to clip videos to respond to for a React channel, or you're just an audio podcaster thinking you want to get in the video game, this is a wonderful tool to utilize. So again, you can check out the link. I'll have it in the description, in the comment section there, and you can take a look at it and see if it's something that might be valuable to you. So let's go ahead and start the full rundown and overview of how to do this. First things first, you go to opus.pro, you log in or sign up for an account, and then you either upload or you drop a link to the video, long form video, that you want to get short form clips from. Now, these aren't just vertical videos, by the way. These can be short 3 to 5 minute highlighted long form videos as well. You can see here it supports links from YouTube, Google Drive, Dropbox, Facebook, Zoom, a whole bunch of things here. So what I'll do is I'll go to my main YouTube for my podcast here, and I'll just copy that episode link here, and I'll go back into Opus. I'll right click and I'll go to paste. You can see I paste the link there and I go to get free clips. When I do that, it opens up a new tab here that shows me kind of what it's working with here. The AI is working to kind of notate what type of video this is. Now, this is something that's new within Opus called Clip Anything that's in beta. If you want to, you can go back to the Clip Basic, but for the purposes of this video, I'm going to show you all of the newest features. So with the Clip Anything features, you can see here that we can let AI detect what type of video it is, but I know this is a podcast, so I can click here into this, notating that the clips that it gets knows that this is a podcast. And we can even click on the settings here within that, and we can turn on or off the prompts or things that the AI is trying to get, right? So you can choose lifestyle, sports, entertainment, informative and educational, and you can even show more if you'd like, okay? Now, the next thing you want to look at here is the include specific moments. If you have a specific moment in the video that you want to capture, you can say, hey, find me all of the touchdowns or find me all of the dunks in this video if it's a basketball clip. And the AI will do that and it will title it and clip those for you. Now, if you are a podcaster and you know for the first 3 or 4 minutes you're kind of opening the show, you can drag the slider here to adjust what time frame Opus pulls the clips from. So I normally drag to the right over here to exclude the intro for my podcast and then drive to the left over here to exclude the outro. So it's only getting the meat or the content of the video. And if you want to, you can look at your long form video and decide when you want to start and finish. Now the bottom here, this is where all the magic happens. You can see that quick presets, all of these are going to be popular creators. Like this one here is Lewis Howe. This one's Mr. Beast. This one's Ali Abdaal. So if you like their stylings, you can just click and select the style that you like. This one's John here, the things that he does. So I'm going to choose Ali Abdaal. I like his settings here. But if you want to, you can go to your templates and you can adjust the presets by going to edit. And it'll open up a new page to where you can go and adjust the color. You can adjust the formatting if you want it to be 9:16. You can do original ratios here. And as you can see, the animation, you can do none, you can do bounce, you can do pop. All of this is for the text here. And you can create your own. But for the most part, I would recommend starting out with these quick presets, finding one that you like. So you can do Alex Hormozi here, you can do his style. But again, I'm going to stick with Ali Abdaal's style for this here. Now we go back up and we go to get clips in one click. Now remember, you need to notate whether or not that the speech language is in the correct language and you want to translate that. Right now there's no translations, but you can choose the language that you're using. And once you're ready to go, you go to get clips in one click. Just shortly, I do want to show you here, if I remove this, I can actually go back here and I can upload a file by clicking upload. And then basically I can go here and upload by clicking upload, and I can upload a longer form video if that is what I want to do. But for the purposes of this tutorial, we're just going to copy and paste the YouTube link and go to Get Clips in one click. Now it says that it's in queue. You can see that it's in queue down here under your projects, and you can often hop between projects. So I can go from a podcast that I did. It keeps it up to 30 days, and I believe you can adjust that if you want. But if you click into a podcast here that's already been completed, you'll see that it's already created the highlights for me. The very top, it gives me a suggested title. It gives me the grades for the value, hook, flow, and trend over here. And if I wanted to, I can even play this back.
I'll just be honest and tell you how I even...
And it tells you all the transcript here of exactly what's said in the video. Now, all of the things over here on the right are actions that we can do with the clip. The first one's going to be share. So we can share this here by clicking share. And we can connect accounts, like I have a YouTube channel here connected. We can add accounts like TikTok feed, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn. And if I connect different accounts, you can upload directly and publish now. I like to export and do my own editing because I don't like the AI to have control over everything. Next, we have export XML. So it'll export in the exact format that you need. The one that I use most is the one here that says download in HD. So I click download just like that here. It'll automatically download it to my downloads folder or wherever it is here. And as you can see, I can go here and I can preview this or play it. And there is the vertical video. And then I put that into other tools that I use, such as Final Cut, and I go and I edit if I want to. But something you can do is you can actually edit the clip here within Opus. If I click on edit, it'll bring up their editor where I can go over here, look at the exact text that's coming up on the screen. And I have a timeline down here where I can go and adjust. So as you can see, if I really wanted to, I could even move the text on the screen. So if it's covering something up, I can click and hold. And as you can see, it moves where the text shows up on that specific video, right? Down here, it works very similar to a timeline in any video editor. You can click and drag left or right to increase or decrease the duration of the video. And if you wanted to, you could even go to automatically add B-roll to your video. So if we click on auto B-roll here, we can go to AI generated B-roll. I found that some of this stuff is good and some is not, as with any AI. But again, this is something that you can do. So if you wanted to, we can go to try now and it'll generate B-roll, takes a few seconds to minutes, and it'll put some automatic, I guess you would say, stock video into your video. Now, while that's loading, I'm going to show you a couple of other things. We can change the transitions here to be whatever we want. We can change it to be a cross zoom, a zoom in, or a fade out. All of this is really personal preference. So that changes kind of the transitions from that. And as you can see, it's added B-roll. So now if we go here and we play the video back, and then if we go here to this section of the video,
then as soon as YouTube Shorts popped up
there. So really cool, some amazing, powerful features here if you're willing to kind of dig in. Next is voiceover. So I went ahead and typed in just a few words here, and the speaker voice, you can select the drop-down menu and choose which voice you want to use. So we'll use Adam, and you can preview.
Our distrust
here
is very expensive.
That's what Adam sounds like here. And then you just click on generate speech, and then you'll have that audio clip to use within your video. Again, these are all powerful features that can help you as a one-man show or as a creator who has a low-end budget. So again, the editor here is wonderful. You got voiceovers, transition, and text here, and then you have your option here. Now, if you want to remove something from the timeline, you just select it and then hit the delete or trash can option here, and you can go and do that. Also, you hit Command or Control Z, like so, and it will undo an action just like it would in a normal application. So you have your timeline here, all the different things that you can edit over here, and then you can always go ahead and hit OK to go ahead and leave that portion of the site. So the editor within Opus is very powerful, is something that I would highly recommend that you try and play around with to really get the best of both worlds. Now, what are we looking at as far as like everything else? So if we go to the homepage here, we can see all of my projects here and save projects. If you want to, you can save projects. And when something is in queue, it'll tell you that this is 17% done, about 25 minutes. Now, what happens when it's complete? So when it's complete, you'll get an email to your linked email to your account that says your clips are ready. And then you just go here, click the blue link that says view clips, and it'll take you directly to where those clips are that you just did and how you want to do those. Now, if we go back here to a couple of other settings here on the left-hand side, you'll see your account info at the top. You'll see brand template and asset library on the left-hand side. I'm not going to go too deep into these. The brand template here basically are settings and templates out to the videos or short-form videos. I've already showed you that earlier. And then the asset library is going to be any assets that you want to add to use for within the editor as you're editing the videos. So if you have, say, an intro that you use for your podcast or an outro for all of your vertical videos, you can upload and add those files here. Next is the calendar. The calendar is something that's in beta, but I'll show it to you briefly. It's basically like a scheduling posting for your social outlets, say TikTok or YouTube. If you have vertical video and you want to upload them on certain days, the calendar will help you kind of streamline that. Analytics is going to be kind of the account views and likes, and you can look at things related to the videos you've published to your connected accounts. I do all of that externally, so I don't have any here. And then under social accounts here, this is just where you'll add your accounts. So if you want to, you see I have my YouTube channel added here. I can go to add account and I can add a TikTok feed, and then it'll ask me to log in to my TikTok account to authorize usage with OpusClip here. So in conclusion, I highly recommend you at least get in here and take a look at what Opus has available to you. It is a very, very powerful tool that allows you to take larger clips, break them down into highlights, and it saves you so much time, okay? Now, let's talk about the subscription model. How does this work? So you can see here, I have an essential plan currently. I have so many credits here, and how many credits basically is how much time or video you can upload. But if you have a plan or a subscription plan, you can see here that we have the different types of subscriptions. You have your pro plans and the essential plan, and it tells you what you'll have access to. If we go to compare plans, you can see here that there is a pro, starter, and a free version. With the pro plan here for $14, you get access to all of this. I would highly recommend that you do this annually because you'll save a ton of money. So if you want access to all of that, you can do that here. So that's it. That's a full rundown and overview and tutorial of how to use OpusClip. If you have any questions, guys, please put those in the comment section below. I've been using this now for about a year, and I was early on, and I'm, you know, partnered with them, and I feel like this is one of the tools in the sea of AI tools that we have that's actually valuable. So definitely check it out if you haven't. Links in the description and the pinned comment. Hopefully this was helpful. Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.